Waheguru Ji Ka Khalsa, Waheguru Ji Ki Fateh. So the 32nd Hukam by Guru Gobind Singh Ji Maharaj, and He Guru Sahib is telling us Guru Upadesh Taran Karne. So Taran He means to adopt. They say that the Guru's Upadesh, the Guru's teachings, adopt them into your life, apply them into your life. So the question is, where are the Guru's Upadesh? Where are their teachings? They're in Gurubani. And now how can we apply those, how can we adopt those into our life? All we have to do is look in Sikhi Japji Sahib and we can find the answer right there. So in Sikhi Japji Sahib, Sikhi Guru Nanak Ji tells us about these three processes we need to go through. The first one being to listen, then to accept, and then to do, to follow. So it's called Sunye, then Manne, and then Nidhyasana is the third one, to do. So Guru Sahib talks about in Sikhi Japji Sahib, in the four podia, the four steps within Sikhi Japji Sahib of Sunye, they say in the third one, Sunye Sata Santokha Gyan. So it's quite cool what they're going to do now. They're going to tell us how much can we gain just from listening to what the Guru is saying to us. So say Taran Karne, to actually adopt them into our lives, but actually just listening to what the Guru is saying to us, they tell us that we gain that truth that we've been seeking in our lives. Sata Santokha, contentment. We gain this contentment just by listening to what Guru Sahib is saying to us, and Gyan. All that knowledge we've been looking for within the world, just by listening to the Guru, we can gain that. Sone Atha Sataka Isanan. Athe means 8. Sata means 60. 68. They're saying to us that in this world, many people go around to these 68 different pilgrimages and they pray. And they do these different types of fasts just to purify themselves. But Maharaj just said, just by listening to what the Guru is saying to us, we can gain that same fall, those same fruits. This one's a cool one. They're saying to us that the people who read and read and read, that honor that people get from doing that, Maharaj says you can get the same honor just from listening to what Guru Sahib is saying to you. Sahajatyan here means that state of not having to try. Just being that state of complete bliss where you're not high, you're not low. Just by listening to what Guru Sahib is saying to us, we gain that sahaj, sahajavastha. After this, we have four podia on accepting. But it's quite interesting here. I'm not sure if people have spotted this. Sometimes we don't realize that in Sikhi Japji Sahib, the first podia of the manne is actually called is manne. So it's with the love, it's manne ki gat. So that means the ones who have accepted. And then the next three is manne, with a dolav, which means the ones, if you accept what the Guru is saying, this is what you'll gain. In the fourth body of talking about acceptance, Guru Sahib Ji tells us, Manne Bhavahe Mokhadwar. Just by accepting what Guru Sahib is saying to us, what will we gain? Mokhadwar. Mokh means mukti. Dwar means the door of mukti, the door of liberation. Manne Bhavahe Mokhadwar, Manne Parivare Sadar. Your parivar, your family, you can save them as well. Manne Tare Tare Gurusikh. They say that if you follow this path, then you yourself will cross this ocean, Tare. They say, Tare Gurusik, and you carry other people across as well, Nanaka Pavahina Pikha. And finally, they say to us that you'll actually stop yourself from wandering in this world as well, in this Charasi Lakjun. So now we've talked about accepting what Guru Sahib is telling us to do. And if you look at the title of the video, which is Taran Karne, to now adopt, to apply into our lives, in the bunch, when we come to Panch Paravan and Panch Paradan, this is Nidhyasana, to do, to apply it into our lives. And Guru Sahib Ji tells us, what do we gain now? If we actually apply those teachings into our life, and they say Panch Paravan. They say those people become Paravan. Panch He means the supreme ones. They become Paravan, they become accepted. Panch Paradan, they become supreme. What does the word Panch mean? We'll just focus on this. It means those ones who listen to Guru Sahib's Upadesh. For example, Panch means Panch as well. So Panch Baniya. They read their Panch Baniya every single day. Something so simple that we take for granted. They wear their Panch Kakar. Why do they wear their Panch Kakar? Because these Panch Kakar help us, refrain us from the evils of the world, to always do positive actions. To know more about that, you can look at our Hukam video which talks about the Panch Kakar as well. And then also, when we talk about Panch, we can talk about the Panch Tat, this body that's made of five elements, to become non-attached to this body. Guru Sahib has given us his whole system, and they say this: if you focus on these five by applying the positive ones, go into the Panch Pyare, for example. Look how common five is in Sikhi. Just by going to the Panch Pyare, we can become Parvan. This is following Guru Sahib's Upadesh, and Maharaj is telling us the way to do this, just to summarize, is through first listening. We have to listen, because if we don't know what the Guru is saying to us, then how can we apply it to our lives later on? So first we have to listen. This is why having an open mind is very important, because then we understand what the Guru Sahib is saying to us. And then from listening, we can accept that. I think, okay, I'm going to try and apply this into my life. And that's when it comes to dharan karne, to actually apply it into your life. And then when we apply that, we'll see that fall itself. So this is the 32nd hukam by Guru Gobind Singh Ji Maharaj, to apply those teachings into our life. The way to do that, Maharaj has taught us simply in Sri Japji Sahib: listen to what the Guru is saying to us, accept it, and just do it. Crack on, as they say, right? Crack on, and Maharaj will do the rest. So please forgive all the mistakes that I've made. Vaheguru Ji Ka Khalsa, Vaheguru Ji Ki Fateh.